Have you ever seen this image around the internet? Yes, that one. Four nerdy looking guys who look like they're gonna show you their Pokemon card collections, against a bright blue background with a single word on the top right corner. Weezer. This charming indie band has made its place in rock history for over 30 years now, releasing album after album dedicated to colors such as red and green, and most notably, their debut The Blue Album. Underneath their goofy facade, Weezer is a band with a deeply complex history. To fully understand Weezer, we must first take a look at their distinctively named singer, Rivers Cuomo. He grew up in a Buddhist commune called Yogaville, and when he left to attend high school, like many other indie musicians, he struggled to fit in and adapt to typical life. However, he found solace in music, falling in love with the band Kiss, and he realized that he wanted to become a professional musician. Straight out of high school, he moved to California, and ended up with the iconic lineup for Weezer, consisting of Rivers and Brian Bell on guitar, Patrick Wilson on drums, and Matt Sharp on bass. The band started off with high stakes. Signed to Geffen Records, they would either make or break in the music scene. However, Weezer was in an odd state of uncertainty. The band considered self-producing, but they eventually decided on Rick Ocasek, the lead singer of The Cars. Ocasek saw the potential of these guys, most notably as they were driving in a car. Ocasek and Weezer were arguing on whether they'd make it or not in the industry, with Ocasek saying the band had great potential and that he was sure they'd be successful. As if to prove his point, he randomly stopped at the side of the road before rolling down the windows and shouting, "Hey, these guys?" before immediately speeding away. In the end, The Blue Album was a commercial success. Many would fall in love with its lighthearted, goofy sound, with losery songs like In the Garage and hits like Buddy Holly. But this nerdy, dorky image was not what Rivers Cuomo intended to put out. He says, "I thought we were the next Nirvana. I thought the world would perceive us that way." To him, the album was a deep dive into his darkest thoughts, such as in Undone, the sweater song, yet all the songs were received through a silly and unserious lens, shattering his dreams of becoming a heartbreaking, emotional rock star. However, the band's discography would take a massive shift in their sound with the release of their next album, Pinkerton. Written while Rivers was studying at Harvard, he decided to name it after a character in the Japanese opera Madama Butterfly, who marries, then later abandons, a woman named Butterfly. It's also important to note that Rivers was recovering from a leg surgery to extend his left leg, which was significantly shorter than his right. With his newfound fame from The Blue Album, he earned a massive money he'd never dreamed of having, and he could finally afford the surgery he needed for years. However, this surgery would put him in immense and prolonged pain, which influenced the harsher, abrasive, and even confessional sound that formed Pinkerton, with tracks like Pink Triangle expressing his experience with unrequited love. And most of Weezer's fanbase weren't exactly thrilled with this drastic shift in tone. Music critics went to describe the album as sloppy and raw. In Rolling Stone, Cuomo's songwriting was even criticized as juvenile. Rivers would then end up in another vicious cycle of self-loathing before reluctantly releasing the Green Album, which mimicked the simplistic and nerdy feel of their debut. Decades later, however, Pinkerton sees a rise in popularity, its edgy, rougher, and more abrasive tones becoming more appealing towards the modern musical ear. At first, Weezer's success almost seemed like a scam, a perfectly calculated industry plant that was criticized for apparently not being quote-unquote true nerds. But the world quickly fell in love with Weezer, recognizing the merits of their entire discography. While it's easy to reduce the band to their wacky and stereotypical nerd-like exterior, Weezer should still be recognized in their entirety. And let's be honest, it's hard not to adore this band,